Guys, and this is Purple Ninja Link, back to the Silver Shovel Run. Last time, made a little bit more progress through the Kanto region. We fixed the power plant, and then headed to, I believe, Fuchsia City. And I actually went back. Oh, the music is kind of loud on my end. I went back and played in the game corner for a little bit so I can get enough coins for this. Because that's insane. So I might actually have to go out for a minute to put away a Pokemon to have room. But as Alakazam will be replacing the first Pokemon at the party. Leecroy. That's a little bit unfortunate. Oh well, TikTok can probably also learn Fly. And my inventory's full. So we're gonna go to the department store. Is this the department store? No. This is the department store. Hey, look, Celadon City has a department store. I didn't go here earlier. We're here now. Hello there, sir. Please take this chunk of solid gold. Yes, thank you. TikTok learn Fly. Let's check that too. I'm gonna have to break my own rules again if TikTok can't learn Fly. Thank goodness. You can forget Peck. Fly will do more damage. Storage. I threw a bunch of stuff in here a while ago. Put away this bright powder, never melt ice, black belt, upgrade, metal coat. Powder. Search G. And the spell tag. And I noticed that my mother must have bought me some healing items at some point. So, should be a lot more reasonable. So now that that's settled. Oh, he's level 15. That's higher than I expected. I'm also actually gonna take this experience share and give it to Boomple. Because Boomple is going to need it more. But now that we've taken care of that, we can go back to Fuchsia City. It's that one. Anyway, and in Fuchsia City, we're gonna go to the gym. This place has invisible walls. Those walls are much easier to see on a larger screen. Also, all of these people look like the gym leader, and that's the other part of the puzzle. So that's fun. Oh, you're a picnicker. That's gonna make my title seem really weird. Buzzbuzz is probably the best suited one here. Everybody knows that bumblebees are the starfish's mortal enemy. They come in contact so much. So there's that. Wow, did Boomple level up twice from that? Jeez. Yes, hello. So, people are clearly not ninjas. You may be wondering why I named the title something about ninjas. Well, I thought that these people were ninjas because in the later games, the people in the poison gyms are usually ninjas. So there's that, I guess. How dare you absorb Buzzbuzz's soul? I can't poison Vileplume, so I'd probably be better suited using Pin Missile. Because as we all know, if a creature has its own form of venom, then it is automatically immune to all other natural venom. That's how biology works. Yay, boom boom. Question mark, boom boom. Last week, that, oh my, I hear a dactyl. Anyway, I think I mentioned last week that I watched some of the early parts of the anime, and the way that they about signature moves was kind of weird. Because, like it said, Charmander's signature move was Rage. But I'm fairly certain they also referred to Rage as Beedrill's signature move. Like, I don't know, it didn't make much sense. You cannot confuse Quiveria. Let's go with Eden. Eden can take this Typhlosion. I keep feeling like there's only so much that I can see that will surprise me. And yet, things like this still happen. The Poison-type gym leader sends out a Typhlosion, and I just have to go, what? Yay, Boom Boom! Boy, it sure would be nice if I could tell what these moves did. You can delete teleport. Dragonair. Well, I don't have anything that would be super effective. Because my only Dragon-type move is a fixed damage move. So I'll try to poison it. As it turns out, Kinesis lowers the target's accuracy. Another Typhlosion? Fire-type gym leader, and he's just not gonna have anything. Yay, Boom Boom. A three! Three Typhlosions! Is your last Pokemon also a Typhlosion? Is it? Like I said, I keep expecting to run out of surprises. And then the game throws three Typhlosions at me in the Poison Gym. Fortunately, fire is one of the only types that I have any coverage for. Wow, that's anticlimactic. Fluorescent. that's something. Okay. He's burned and stopped being on my screen. I guess I'm going back to Cerulean anyway. I think... Can I even... Oh, jeez. I'll start by coming to Lavender Town. Serves. Oh, right! So, the radio programs, the radio music, actually does affect Pokemon. So I believe that if I go out with this playing, I will encounter sleeping wild Pokemon. This is a lullaby. We're gonna try it one more time. Maybe not. Maybe it's just a chance. Since we have that Poke Flute, we can go... It's a Vermilion City. I think it's Vermilion City. There was a Snorlax in the road. Yeah. It's here. I don't have a Pokemon from this area. Let me just double check. So yeah, instead of actually using the Poke Flute item, you just put your radio next to it, and the Snorlax wakes up, and it's a Butterfree. It's a level 4. Oh crap. Is, I can get to Diglett's Tunnel now. Cool. And Diglett's Tunnel. So am I in Viridian Forest? Is that why it's playing that music? Yeah, that would be Viridian Forest. Okay. So once I figure out how to get out of here, can I get to that tree? Not without trying way harder than I want to try. Okay. Just gonna cut down this tree. Drat. Oh, it's Slugma! Hello, Slugma. Do I really not have a Slugma? And then I have to replace them with it. The problem is I can't weaken it. Because anything I do would kill it. So... I think either Eden or Buzz Buzz. I've already used my clever Slugma family nickname. Just name her Q. And Q will be replacing Buzz Buzz. Also, I'm poisoned, so here, have flashing pink. Existence of this Slugma. And reasonably, I feel like I should not switch in Q because I already have a Mag Cargo. That's not in my rules. So... we have a Slugma. Anyway, this is Pewter City. There's a gym here. We're gonna fight it. You know, as we do. I am ready for this. I am curious how many rock types you're actually going to have. Yep, that's not a rock type. That's a marshmallow. In a later generation, this would be a very bad idea. But in this generation, it's fine. Touché. I don't know why I picked Thunder Wave again. It didn't work anyway, though. So this is fun. Come on, Wolverine, wake up. Ah. You know Solar Beam? Oh, did it use Metronome? Might have missed that. That was Metronome, because I object to a Fable being able to use Solar Beam. Yeah, that must have been Metronome. Oh no, you're ruining the meta. To be fair, while it's not a rock type, the Fable still has really high special defense. So this is still taking forever. Can you please actually be paralyzed? Like, pretend to be paralyzed? It doesn't matter now. At least Boomful leveled up. Good luck with that. Hello, Brock, fight me. I can almost guarantee you that your Pokemon are not going to be rock types. Case in point. They're getting closer to my level. Actually, since his first Pokemon is level 41, his other Pokemon will probably be higher level than I am. He'll probably have at least one that's a higher level, anyway. Oh, you've got an Alakazam. I don't have a B anymore. But I have a Slug. Look, isn't it cute? I also have a bigger, slightly angrier Slug. As a shell. Oh my. Oh wow. That did a lot of damage. I'm not going to survive another one of those. I'm not even gonna get to attack. This doesn't bode well. Alakazam, why are you so fast? Well, thank you. Area is probably my best shot. That assumes Waveria can survive more than one turn. Look, I have a spoon as well. I actually have two of them, but you can't see the other one. I don't feel like this is gonna go well. I mean, I'm not gonna survive to use Disable, but it's a nice thought. Okay, Waveria. Please stop his madness. You gotta run out of power for that eventually. It's also a really annoying sounding attack. Of course, if you could actually be fully paralyzed for once, that'd be nice. Thank you. See, if I still had Buzz instead of that stupid slug. It's gonna do exactly 44 damage. This should do exactly enough. Well, it should be enough to kill it. Oh, thank goodness. I was getting worried there. Execute. No, won't change. Heal, though. Oh, you want to be paralyzed, huh? This is how you paralyze. Okay. There are grass types, but water types aren't going to do much. Just unleash Righteous Dragony Vengeance upon you. That'll work. Seeking. Paralyze you.
Okay.
pretty much my option. You're a fish. My water-type moves won't do much against you. If he just keeps using Fury Attack, though, I should be fine. Because it does, like, 7 damage per hit. That was way closer than I wanted it to be. I still have mixed feelings about this Slugma, though. I don't want to amend one of my rules just because something inconvenient happened. But I don't know, I'm trying to avoid having duplicates. So I feel like having a Pokemon that can evolve into one of my other Pokemon counts as a duplicate. The tree. So they redecorated the forest and they had to move the bug catchers somewhere else. Wow, that's actually a bug. I'm proud of you. I'm also gonna drop a rock on it. Fine. Stop that. Do you know any moves that aren't just there to be annoying? Great. Oh. Well, there's one. I can drop a rock on that too. Well, you tried and that counts for something. Thank you. He doesn't count for any more because you did it again. Sweet. Oh heck yeah, boom boom. Man, I'm glad that other Alakazam didn't use Recover. That would have been obnoxious. Thanks, Mom. I like how I send money to my mother for safekeeping, and she just buys a bunch of random crap with it. Like, I'm sending it to you so I have savings. This gym also doesn't have a leader right now. It's not locked, though. Yay, Barry. Schoolboy Danny. I could fight you, but I don't want to. Burn. Giraffarig is such a strange poke. Answer. I can burn that too. He threw the earth. Or exactly 31 damage. Because that's how seismic toss works. Yay, Ash. Dewgong. I should probably switch for that. That's something Boopal could probably take out. You got this, Boop. I believe in you. Yeah, I didn't figure that was gonna work. Oh, wow. Go TikTok. Survived an Aurora beam. Something that would normally be here. I do think that for the future, I'm not going to allow Pokemon that evolve into Pokemon that I have. It's one thing if I had to switch out a Pokemon before I got a chance to, and then I get its evolved form, like with Wooveria, because I started with a Dratini, but I've never had Eradicate. I'm replacing Ash with this thing. Your name will be Purple. I should be able to fly here now. Yeah. So I'll fly back to Viridian City. And heal up and then swap out. These rules would be more reasonable if the Johto, well, if the Kanto region was balanced. That's what gets me. The fact that all of these Pokemon be practically useless. Yes, I want to surf. Time to catch another. No, I've had an Oddish. At least the Pokemon here are a reasonable level. I could catch these. Or one of them. Not an Oddish, though. I've already had them. So goodbye. Can you be something that's not an odd? Ergoldine. I had a Sea King. Doesn't look. I think I can catch. catch you. So that's kind of nice. It'll turn immediately less nice if you end up replacing Eden or Wyveria. But, hey, that's how the shuffle run works. Sometimes, you have to swap out Pokemon and it sucks. It's like a Nuzlocke, except instead of putting a Pokemon in the box forever, you're forced to put it in your party immediately. Get in the ball. Okay, who are you replacing? You're replacing Purple. I'm okay with that. Your name will be... Floop. Hello. Please heal me. And then let me put my rat in your computer and get my fish out instead. Real quick, what route is that? 21. I'm tempted to get Buzz back out to make up for the whole Slugma thing, but I think that I don't think I can enact that rule retroactively. Plus, now I don't have Ash. Because of this thing. At least Floop could be good. Floop's a decent level. But, you're now on Cinnabar Island. Or, well... Hi, Blue. So yeah, Blue's the gym leader of Viridian City. And I believe... Hello, Chinchou. I've already caught one. I should give Q a smoke ball. I believe that somewhere in the Seafoam Islands, there is a replacement for Cinnabar Gym. squad of Magnemite. Still paralyze you, I do believe. Oh no, Sonic Boom. That'll do exactly 20 damage. How could you? Great ball. It's a great ball. You should stay here. No. Drat. Got one more of these, then I'm gonna switch to the Ultra Ball. Check what 5 is. I will name you Toll. Back 7 feet. It's Boom Pole. I'm replacing Boom Pole. That's unfortunate. Didn't even get to a high enough to be useful. I have to save because I'm switching boxes. I'm sorry, Boom. Switch to box 3. It's a good thing that it didn't require you to save every time you switched a box in later games. I understand that it was probably a necessity. Data management. But it's still kind of annoying. Hello, crap. crap. Well, my party's somewhat reasonably leveled. My only two powerful Pokemon, or my two most powerful Pokemon, are water types, though. Or primarily have water type moves, anyway. You don't know me. Just use Sonic Boom. That's a guaranteed damage move. What? Oh, come on now. Those aren't supposed to be able to hit you unless the Pokemon's a lower level than you. That's just annoying. Are you bloody serious? Stop. So done with your crap, Krabby. Experience wasn't even worth it. The experience still just isn't enough to be worth it. Probably don't have any repels. I should check though. I mean, a repel wouldn't really work all that well anyway. What? What do you mean I can't escape? Thank you. There's a gym here. You'd better have burn heal. He's got a Dunsparce. Dunsparce being terribly good. It kind of just is. I mean, that did a lot more damage than I expected it to be fair. Now you're gonna knock yourself out. And a shuckle. Now, given the difficulty I had getting here, I was kind of concerned. I mean, he could always pull out an Alakazam or something. But... Thank you. Actually using an attack. I am somewhat impressed by that. Wow. Yeah, you're actually gonna take out Eden. Fortunately, I have another Pokemon. Unfortunately, you have a potion. Surprised I haven't encountered that before, though. Fortunately, you can't poison me. Though that did do a lot of damage, I will break. Bad time to be fully paralyzed. And you do it. Holy crap, maybe. That's my option. I'm honestly surprised that this Weezing didn't just explode at some point. significant amount of damage. I mean, experience. So, have you been here this whole time? Oh. No, he hasn't. So, now that that's settled, I'm going to fly on this knocked-out bird back to Viridian City. And I'm gonna heal him. I'm gonna run to the bathroom real quick, but I'll be right back after that. And now that I'm in Viridian City, I'm gonna fly to Cerulean City. Because I want to check again to see if Misty's back. Does Misty even exist? Is there something I'm missing? I feel like I might be missing something. But in any case, I'm gonna give Blue a shot. Blue doesn't actually specialize in anything normally. So yeah, after his brief stint as a champion in Red and Blue, oh dear, he actually does have his Alakazam and it's level 56. I'm not gonna stand a chance. I mean, at least Pole resists Psychic. See? That was about what I expected. So, I'm gonna need to train a bit before I can beat Blue. Because this is very obviously not going to work. Of course it was a critical hit. Eh. Yeah. I thought we might stand a chance. I thought wrong. His Pokemon are over 10 levels higher than any of mine. So, I'm gonna call it here. I might train up a little bit off screen. I don't know. But we'll see. And I guess that's kind of funny. Next week might be an indie intermission, because that might be March 1st. Yeah, that will be March 1st. So next week will be an indie intermission. And then we will pick up from there in a couple of weeks. Till then, thank you guys for watching, and have a good day.